Let us start. I think we will do that exercise later because some of you want this topic to be covered. Because anyway, you have got the methodology, so you can do that exercise about choosing topic and get back to me. My email ID is here. Anyone can contact me anytime for any inputs like that. Just a moment, I am drawing your attention again to the research process, and I am linking this third topic with this activity. Continuous literature search is expected at all through your research work. So how to do that literature search is I am now going to focus. Understand? So this activity will last till your last draft. Because tomorrow you are going to submit and today something new may appear, you have to take cognizance of that. See, you understand the term literature, means any document written on any subject, any topic. But when you are talking in context of research, you are talking about research literature like that. So what it is, how to locate it, that will be the focus of this presentation. Then what use this literature is to be made of, that will be my next topic. Now how documents have evolved. For last 5000 years we have got written historical documents. The more of those sources or documents were different. It was basically handwritten manuscripts, clay tablets, papyrus in Egypt, like our Bhojpatra, they used to write on the tree bark, papyrus. Then came the typing, print material, microfilm, audio video films, and then now digital. So depending on your research topic, document which is acting as a source of reference for you could be varying from top to bottom or perhaps all also. Because if you are working in nowadays historical records, you may require manuscript also, you may require digital book also. You know, so there is no hard and fast rule that this research will only this source, nothing like that. It will vary from topic to topic. But I am just giving by and large the research material could be in any of these forms. You understand? All are manuscripts, lifetime work of somebody, you know, handwritten and still in very good shape. And see the colors, you know, how colorful they had made like that. Now, this is Matsya Purana, so written on the shape of the, like that. Gaja Purana, no? So. But you can imagine not multiple copies will be existing, because it used to take years together to write one such manuscript. That's why it become valuable. But this may be very much required if you are working on ancient topics or you want to make a comparison with older topic with the new topic, then this become very important source of reference like that. See, Akbar has got translated Ramayana in Persian language. Yes. He wanted to know why is India still wants to talk about Rama. So he got Ramayana translated like that. So you know, they have got their own importance. This was the clay tablet, Sumeria. On a clay tablet, they are just marked and complete knowledge of whatever that area, including mathematics and all these things, are there in such clay tablets, very few are available, and that is the papyrus roll. The complete Euclidean geometry is on those papyrus rolls. There are 13 volumes, 13 rolls or scrolls. Each scroll is one part of the what is called elements. the geometry of Euclid is written 13 scrolls, and there are 13 volumes like that. Then a Chinese folded book, you know, book also went different fashion. Then the parched paper like that, and this codex book. This made a tremendous difference, because if you want to locate anything, you have to really open a complete scroll. When this design came to, it's called a codex book. So all our books are now codex books. So this now looks very ordinary, but this was a big decisive moment in the history of literature, like that. And then of course, I need not talk about this digital form. So content is important, form could be different, it is the point. So with respect to literature for research, I am calling as data source type. One is the books. I am talking about research book, not the textbook like that. But what is the definition of the book? You have been using the book, but have you ever paid attention how book is defined? See, UNESCO has given this definition, very simple definition. A document is to be called as book if it contains 49 plus pages, is more than 49 pages, and it should have one identifiable parameters, either author or publisher. If such document, then it is to be called as book. Understand? And then books have got another aspect of book can be published any time in the year. There is no fixed frequency. It could be brought in January, it could be brought in March. There is no fix like that. That becomes important later. If the book is devoted to a very sub area of research, then it is called monograph or treatise like that. Very specific area like that. The other source, very important source, is serial or periodical or journal. Now journal has got this definition that it should be periodical. It could be monthly, it could be bi-monthly, it could be quarterly, it could be yearly. So it has to come out after every 3 months, every 6 months, whereas book can come out any time. So this is a big difference. And of course, since it is coming out so periodically, journal will be giving latest information. Book publication takes about 1 year, 1.5 year. So you get the results which were 1 year older. Whereas journals will be reporting within, say, 3 months also what has happened. So that's why in scientific research or any research, journals is a main source of reference. Then manuscript, as I have told you, for summary, or personal papers, many political science studies, historical studies, personal papers play a very important part. The correspondence between Nehru and Gandhi, or between Churchill and Roosevelt, you know, all these are very important documents. They were just letters. So that become important source of reference for that kind of research. Government documents, important census books, government reports, fact-finding commission reports, again very vital for certain researches. Now such reports have no frequency. They can come out as and when commission completes and submits the report and accept it. Reserve Bank of India brings out what is called occasional papers. So that's why it is called occasional papers. There is no frequency. In 1 year they may bring out 6 papers, next year no paper, after next year 2 papers, depending on the occasion. If they find that something extraordinary has happened on inflation rate, then they will bring out occasional paper. It is a very good, well-studied document, but still the frequency is varying. That's why it's called occasional paper. So for economics and many such areas, this is a very vital source. Archives, it's called the government archives. All the government documents are submitted, are put in archives. So all GRs, all the government gazette notifications, memoirs, legislation, budgets, everything is put in government archive. So if you want to do research based on that, you must visit government archive and you can get permission to download for academic purpose. Then reports of private organization, annual reports of many companies, or even individual collection. Manuscripts is many times individual collection. It is not available to everybody. So you must first locate the person who will have that manuscript, then request him. So it is very long drawn process. Then original arts, that is also a source of reference for some of the work in fine arts research, or sculptures and all these kind of drawings, paintings, old city plans, they are very important for city planning like that. Films and tapes, audio video, another source of reference. Prints, graphic art, engravings, lithographs, woodcuts and computer generated prints, photographs, positive, negative, aerial photographs, satellite imageries, x-rays, scanned images, all these are source of reference for research in medical and other fields. Even physical objects, building, furniture, tools, appliances. If you are working on history of science, then you like to see what Faraday used to prove his laws. So that is very important, physical object as a source of reference, and digital collection. Now, this is a whole list. You can now think of for your research, generally what kind of data sources are required. And again, you can talk to experts and they will tell you, you please refer to this kind of document also. And where you will find this collection? That's why library still remains very important, even in this internet era, because library has been doing this service to the society for more than 500 years. They have been really collecting the information, manuscripts, all those things judiciously. Generally, they are not taking very trivial items. So textbooks, academic books and research books. So even if you are using Google and all this kind of thing, don't underestimate the power of library. And if the older documents, especially library will have, it may not be digitized, so no digital site will be able to give you like that. So if you are using a library, prepare a search plan, and I will explain you how you are going to search this library. Each library has its own peculiarity, its own way of organizing the collection. So you have to prepare a plan so your time is minimized for searching. See, very good research library, see the variety of collection it can have. Have you ever consulted this top line, those who are doing researches? There are so many journals being published. So this is a Ulrich directory which brings out the list of all journals published in the world. Understand? Huge exercise they are doing. Every 4 years they bring out the complete list with some details. Who is the editor, editorial board, what is its policy, what is editorial policy. So you know, such information. So you are working in say computer science or database management, and they are given the index also. So you can search to the data index, database management portion, and you will find there are 176 journals. Today no one can tell you, but this is not known to you. That's why this is where you will get it in library. Nowhere else you will get this directory. That's why please visit your research library. University libraries will definitely have what is called Ulrich directory. And every 4 years they are bringing up, because some journals fold up, some journals change their name, some journals change their policies, new journals. So all that thing is reflected in that list. So as a researcher, please consult this library. And then you can do what is called ABC analysis of journals and pick up the journal where I should submit my paper. You know, variety of things you can do. So library service, this kind of thing. Then Directory of Indian Periodicals, Union Catalogue of Indian Periodicals, means ICCSR and many such bodies, they have got volumes, and where, which are the journals published in India. and in which library they are available, from which volume to which volume, which is missing issue, all that is available in such union catalogs. So you are doing research on say economics, econometrics. So in India, which are the journals available published by Indian or others, and which are available in say Mumbai University Library, Ahmedabad, and from which volume? Some libraries may have right from the first issue of first volume. Some may have in between, and suppose you want in between, then you can get guidance. I must go to Ahmedabad and visit this library and get the particular journal issue or article. So this is a very important source. Abstracting journals, because you know such journals they are coming out, they are giving the abstracts. So some journals are just giving the abstracts. Every 3 months they bring out abstracting journal, say in social science, in biological abstract, chemical abstracts. So every quarterly or chemical abstract almost weekly now, they are telling you within these last 3 months they have got standard journals, what articles were published, their abstract or summary, their author, keywords and the email of the author. So you can just read that abstract 150 words and see the keywords. If they are matching with you, read that article, you can obtain from the author or from journal. So for researchers, this is also one of the important step, consult the abstracting journals. Then dissertation abstract, thesis abstracts. All research public thesis of US universities are available through dissertation abstracts. All disciplines, all the PhD thesis of US universities are available there. Complete abstract, so you have got nearly 2 pages summary of each thesis. If you feel, then you have to pay and get the full thesis also. They are providing this service. Now UGC through Shodh Ganga etc. is providing this kind of service like that, our country. Then electronic journals, many of the journals now are electronic forms, so you can get their access through library like that. Subject bibliography, electronic databases, microfilms, maps, you know, you cannot get it everything online. So good research libraries, please consult as many libraries in India as possible for your topic. And how gray literature, yeah, I'll be talking about it and coming to that. Now this is how classically library was organized. You have books shelved there according to some scheme, and there are what is called the catalog cards. So if you know the author, there are 3 cards per book. One author wise, surname wise they are arranged, or title wise, or subject wise. So if you know the author, you can just go to that part of the catalog cards, their surname. So you say Bose, then their initials. So you have say R.C. Bose, so you get all the books of R.C. Bose listed together, and its call number will be there, in which cupboard the books are. So we are guided there. But you don't know the author, but you know the title, then you can search through title. Or you don't know both, then okay, it falls in mathematics. Then mathematics cards are there. So this was a traditional way of organizing the information about the documents in the library. Now with computer, we have changed the system. It is called OPAC, Open Public Access Catalog. It means all the things now put on the website of the library, so that you can search from the home also. So you before coming to library, you know which cupboard I should go like that. So it's called OPAC, but some of the older libraries will still have both the systems. That's why I'm saying start planning your activity. Okay. So they organize through sometimes new decimal system mostly. Three, so they have got a system from 0 to 999. 0 to 99 is general, religion, etc. So books are according to given the number like this. 100 to 200, 119 something, 200 like that. So 300.72 means it is social science. So 501 to 509 is general science, 5010 is mathematics, up to 519 is statistics, and so on. So if you know those class numbers, librarians can tell you, and you can go straight away and search like that. And that is the bookmark 300.72/BLA, means first author's surnames, three characters are given. So there may be many books under 300.72 on the shelf. So this bookmark says that his author was white. So 300.72 WHI. So you can go straight way to that book and pick it out. So this is how the books are stored in the bookshelf. Sometime if there is a one area like census books, they are having some class number, but it is a big series, so it is kept separately. It is called broken order. So librarian can tell you, if you are looking out for United Nations document, they are not put with, because United Nations is dealing with so many topics. So some part will go to sociology, some will go to psychology, some will go to economics. So it will be very difficult to locate. So many libraries, what they do, one big institutions, their all collection is put together. It's called broken order. So order is broken for a particular group. So you know, but every library will have a different scheme. So you tell the librarian that I am looking out for such documents, then they can guide you. So we'll go to now online sources. There are some of the standard sources, Oxford Analytica. Up-to-date information of, see, only two subjects, political and economic situation. You want to get anything about that, this is very authentic and good source. If you are talking about human rights, women's studies, then different countries. Then CQ, Global Researchers, in-depth analysis of issues, 85,000 printages, full text available. So, you know, this kind of information, the Elias profession will give you better. That's why the library profession is very important even today. If they are keeping abreast, then they can really provide the service which will save your time. Because if you just give something with India, and Google says 10,000 pages, it is humanly impossible to read all those 10,000. There will be so many duplication, so many nonsense like that. So their librarian's role is to tell you exactly which source to be referred to. I'll be coming to a gray literature now here. So for researchers, the literature is divided into four classes. One is called primary source. Primary means original research material. When you conduct a survey or you write an algorithm, you are generating primary source of data. Understand? So this is called the primary source. Means first appearance of research results is primary source, like that. Means original research paper or raw data you have made observation laboratory, like that. Live speech, recording of live event, videotape of performance, autobiography also. They are all forming what is called the primary source of data. It is not depending on anything else. That's why even autobiography, because I am writing my experiences. Biography is secondary, autobiography is primary. Understand? So think now for your research whether you require this kind of source. If not, most of you will start with this. Yeah. Huh? What you? Yes, primary data. If you design a robo, it is a primary data. But something like this is called secondary data. Means somebody has processed that data and given its output. And so he is not the original creator, but he is interpreting it. So commentaries, evidence interpretation, all law cases, they are forming the secondary data. Review article is also secondary data. Understand? Research article is primary data, but review article, because you are reviewing how other people have done the research and what were their outcomes. So review article is secondary data. Biography, secondary data. Bibliography, secondary data. Handbook, secondary data. Data compilation directories, patent index, textbook, all are secondary. They are not reporting anything original. So this may be starting point. You start with secondary, then you generate your own like that. Journals, etc. will be starting point. Then tertiary, third level. It lists primary and secondary together. Understand? It is further away from the primary source like that. Encyclopedia. It is a tertiary source. Or almanac, or chronology, directory, dictionary, they are all tertiary sources. Tertiary means not least in importance, but they are indirectly giving the information. See? And there is a very thin line, because some data which are primary, like manuscript, it may be printed today as a book. So from primary it may become secondary, and then somebody writes commentary on that, it becomes tertiary. Understand? So there could be a transformation. So again, it varies from subject to subject. And this is your grey literature. Means literature, a form of document which cannot be labeled either as a book, periodical or manuscript. Like a leaflet, a newsletter. See, conference is announced, one page leaflet comes. It is not a book, it is not a periodical, it is not a manuscript. That's why it's called grey literature. It cannot be classified in the standard source of reference. But it is very important for certain researches, like election manifesto. It comes in 10 pages. So it is not a book, it is not periodical, it is not booklet in that sense also. But for political science, that is the source of reference. Now suppose somebody wants to do analysis that how Indian National Congress has been promising to the voters over the last 10 elections. So what is the main source? Their manifesto, election manifesto. Now I doubt very much even Congress headquarters will not have all those manifestos of first election. So some libraries have taken care to store them. They have not thrown it away. Congress party has thrown away all those manifestos. But they are really understood the importance and preserve them. So you have to go to government archives or those libraries where such grey literature is very important in that sense. Is it clear now, grey literature? It is neither black and white in that sense, so it is called grey literature. Okay. When you get the literature, you are collecting a data in a sense. So you have to also collect what is called metadata, mean data about data. Means it's basically characteristics. Very simple, like ISBN number or serial ISSN number. Because these are the details which are helping you in variety of ways. If you want to place the order, just type ISBN number and correct book will come to you, because you may spell wrongly, you may not give title correctly, but ISBN is unique. It is linked to the title author perfectly. It is a global system. It was developed for computer transaction like that. So this is a metadata, data of the book in this ISBN number. So one number is sufficient to place the order like that. Then many other things, what is called imprint information, who is the publisher, and all those details called a metadata. So for researcher, you have to note down all these things, because when you are giving at the end the references, you have to produce all these details. The author, exact title, place of publication, publisher, in which year, in which edition, which particular pages you want, all that details is covered under broader term called metadata. And similarly, for now digital objects, you have got DOI. unique, like ISBN there, DOI, Digital Object Identifier. This is also a number. You must have been seeing it. Even if you do the Google search, if you go down, they say DOI, and a big number is there. So you click on that, you can get all the information. Right? So DOI is very important for digital objects. Now, how we do search for the primary sources? We first go to the research journals. You are asking how to start. So first we go to the primary source, means research journal, which are peer reviewed internationally recognized journals. And that's why that Ulrich directory becomes helpful. There are 150 journals in my area. So which are the best one? So their impact factors and their peer reviewed or not. So you can make ABC classification. These 20 are the most important, then next 75 and next. And here librarian, your subject specialist, mentors can tell you, these are the best journals, ABC like that. So you must first concentrate the papers published in that journals. Then research level monographs or books which are available in the library or on level. Conference proceedings, this is very important nowadays. You have done some research, you may not send it immediately for publication. You may submit it to the upcoming conference, national, international. They may or may not bring it out in the proceedings form, but they are saying it has got merit, you can orally present it. So later on, it may go through peer review process or they may publish as it is, but it will be reporting most recent results. So conference proceedings is also a very important source for research. Doctoral thesis, of course, available. Then research reports brought up by government or say IBM or such noted companies. Then e-journals, electronic journals, electronic databases, and specific research discovery tools and search engines. They are all primary tools to be explored. Then abstracting journals, thesis abstracting documents, which I told you, government publications, committee reports, commission reports, census, government acts, resolution, they are very vital, but they are secondary, and in the trade magazines. Directories, yearbooks, subject dictionaries, subject specific encyclopedias, they are all tertiary sector, but very important for research, especially for definitions. If you have to define certain thing, then encyclopedia and that specific dictionary becomes, subject dictionary becomes very important. See how many sources are available, both print as well as online. You just name a topic or any field, see in computer science, applied science, computer literature index, current contents, bio, complete knowledge in that specific field is available, and you just click on that, you will get further details like that. Huge list is there, you know, covering all the disciplines, all the fields, social sciences, environment sciences, urban studies. Many publishers are bringing it, like SAGE, they are bringing it. Just see how many sources are available now. You choose even one topic, you can get so many starting points. Right? So, and this is still not full list. There are some more I am not able to make right. Okay. Yeah. Now, decide your search objectives. There's a huge body of literature available. There are various schemes. Should I go by country publication? Means I will concentrate only about the Indian context. Many sociologists or economists, they say we don't want global thing, we want Indian thing. So your search strategy will be different. Somebody say I will concentrate only on this particular language, only English language literature. But somebody say no, we want German also, because lot many German scientists have been contributing to this area, and so on. So that another strategy. Date of publication, some subjects such that where older data is important. History, 100 year old book or journal is important than the recent one. But in physics, anything below 20 years back, throw it away. they say, now before 2000, book of physics is of no use for researchers. That is what, you know, so every subject has got its own time period of peak and off peak. So think about that, again talk to people and decide on that. Or type of publication. Somebody say we will concentrate only on journals, somebody say only on research monographs, somebody say all the three things or in database. So set your objectives, how you want to search the literature. Then how to record that information. See, when I started research, this was the practice. So here I have written the surname and the first name of the author. Then I have given its full title, the publishing place, publisher's name, in which year this book was published. If it is next edition, then edition number. How many pages are there? Then in which library I saw that book? What was its class number? So if I got to go back, I need not do all these things. I can go straight to that book. And on which date I borrowed this book. This is the metadata I written. On the back side, I written my comments. Topics covered, level, some important keywords, and some other notes. So this is how we used to write information about all the books and arrange them alphabetically. But you can imagine how tedious it was. But this was the way we did the research. Now you have got online sources to even organize all these things. But this was also a standard method, and still older time you will find such cards are, people are still writing like that, because this is in your control. Now there are software tools available, and perhaps Madam will show you also how to use these tools like that. How you conduct it. So start with very loose framework. Give broader key terms to be searched. Say you are doing online search. Don't go to that particular immediately. Start with slightly broader term like that. Then once you get a broader team and you come to know that people are using this kind of terminologies which are relevant for your topic, then form up those as keywords or technical descriptors of your topic. Because what happens, different people use different terms for the same concept. Understand? Say if I am doing transport planning, something like that. If I go to the British journal, they use the term footpath, which we are using because we have got that legacy. But in US journals, there is no term like footpath. They call it curb or curbside. So if I give footpath, no American article will come. Understand? That's why Google is saying like this or not like that, same as this. But it has got limitation. That's why if you do road planning, then you will get to know what kind of words are used by different, even English speaking people in different countries. So you'll have to search your database using these kind of terms to get full picture. Now, depending on your topic, you have got so many sources, right from manuscript to research journals to profile magazines, conference proceedings, government archives, and web sources like that. Now, can you make a difference between research journal and professional magazine? It is both are periodical with some frequency, fixed frequency. But can you just think of why I am making these two as separate? Right. So research journals are considered to be higher ones because it is really reporting research based outcome, experimental. Yeah, and trade magazines means devoted to same area, they also reporting some research investigation, but their focus will be slightly of trade nature. They will also have many other information like upcoming conferences, new publications, and so on like that. So just to show example, now this is example of research journal. It comes every 3 months, its editorial policy, everything is given, how to write a paper, how they want, all these details are there, how to give the references. So all it is not giving any other advertisement, nothing like that. So generally journals will be like this. Vis-a-vis Science Now, it is talking about science, maybe physical science, chemical science, commercial, but it is talking about so many other things also, popular articles, some conference proceedings, some books, and so on like that. So they are also equally important, but journal is treated as one step above the theory. But you must consult professional periodicals also in your chosen field, because they will be giving you lot of other information which journals will not be giving. So always consult both the things like that.
Can we say that journal is more of primary and professional magazine is more of secondary?
Yes, slightly. They are both important, but yeah, if you have to compare, then journals is the topper one, top priority. No, see. No, no, see, if they achieved that status, say like Scientific American, it is not a research journal in that sense. It is still science popular in journal, but its reference, because they really engage the authors who are really masters in their field and they want to popularize their work, so they have commissioned them to write in simple language. So there are no mistakes. But still, vis-a-vis research journal, No. It is not like that. They are giving same information, but they may not given so many references. Their length could be restricted. They may be given more figures, which normal journals will not like to give. Style of presentation different, but content-wise, right. But all the science professional magazines are not given as references. Understand? In references giving, you make a difference. Many times, these kind of professional magazines are not included in the references. It depends on your thinking, how you look at that professional magazine. That's why I'm saying, so many of the scientists, when they have to publish a research paper, they make a distinction. They will never give newspaper as a reference. And because you know, newspaper, there is no credibility. Tomorrow they will apologize, they will retract back. So newspaper is out of question. Some of the journals, the reviewer says, you should not quote from this magazine because they have got stance. See, some of these even science periodicals have got particular stance, or they tilt. Say Christian Science Monitor journal is there, that way very good journal, but they have got everything towards Christianity. So there is a tilt in their writing, subtle writing is tilting toward that. So many of the journals, if they come across such references, they question it and they say whether it is unbiased reporting or viewpoint like that, or you are just including it for making comparison, then it is acceptable. But if that view is the basis of your all research, then they will question you. That's why you have to be very careful when giving them as a source of reference, especially when you are published. Yeah. That comes by your experience.
Really, in the editorial, that idea is, what is their methodology?
No, but as he is starting research and writing thesis, he has no editorial assistance today.
Right,
unless he submits a paper and get this feedback, that is what he is saying, that how right in the beginning I can avoid that. That is your point? That's what I'm saying. So there, that's why if you consult and discuss with your guide, many experts, they can tell you subtly because they have got a lot of such reading and experience. You yourself can also develop that judgment, but overnight it doesn't come up. That is also very true. No, there is no definition like that. But that's why, see, they give editorial policy. Each journal gives editorial policy. But this is not given in professional magazines. And that is the difference what I'm saying. The journal will generally give, we want only theoretical paper. We want theory plus application. Or we want only application paper. Paper should not exceed 5,000 words. Everything is given here explicitly. Whereas professional magazines, they welcome 2,000 words article sometimes. Depending on the occasion, they will put 5,000 words article. And, you know, there is variation. So they are not so strict in really giving the documents like that. Any point?
The debate kind of things, those are available in professional magazines, but they are not the part of the journals.
No, some journals allow that.
Debate,
yes. If I send my comments on one of the papers that what this argument or
that's comment.
No. Then this is sent to the author. Author replies back and both are produced as debate.
That I got. It is not. I'm saying something else. Depending upon the occasional points they provide and they invite opinions on that and create article
that's what
out
I'm
of
saying.
That.
So
also.
That is the way.
Featuring those
professional
things.
Meetings and all those things. They are proceeding. But even journals allow this debate.
Yeah, that,
if
that's
the issue
true.
Is
that
really
done,
critical, otherwise they don't do it. If you have got a very trivial comment, they will not bother author with that. They will say, you don't want.
Yeah, but then comments by the researchers are always welcome since
yeah, but they will be reported if they are worthy. So they will send to the author, they will do this whole exercise. And there may be two or three rounds also. You know, they may not publish
it. Even we can see the comments on the articles available in some other journal.
Yes,
since our Indescript articles, which was published in some other journal.
Yes, yes.
Comment happened in some other journal. That is also there. They invite that kind of comment.
So that is now that editor of the journal decides whether we should entertain comments on other paper in our journal. If they are matching to the subject of their interest, then they will do it. Otherwise, it won't like that. Understand? So you'll have to refer to most of these sources. Again, I'm saying, don't leave out even grey literature for certain researches. That is important. Okay, I need not talk about this. So that World Wide Web and Internet, that becomes very important for you, and I think this is the important part. See, there are so many different kinds of websites. So for research, which sites to be really referred to? Very important. So that last part of that protocol address is now reflecting on the kind of organization. There could be archive sites. So generally it is authentic because government reports are put there. Now business site is dubious, which is ending in .com, etc. Community site is also not up to the mark many times because it is again giving one-sided view on certain issues like that. Database site is okay, development site, directory site is okay, game site. So, you know, so again your computer science experience become very helpful by looking at that protocol and home page. And that's why again library science professionals are trained into that, how to evaluate the website for its quality, its authenticity. There are various parameters to do that. Either you get training in that and do it yourself or take the help of the people who are knowledgeable in that domain. Web portal, I'm not. So generally, website is arranged in this fashion. And those who have got better navigation scheme, they should be preferred like that. Yeah. So they are standard one. If they are ending in EDU, means that website is education, or .ac, name of the country. That is, AC means academic. Understand? Either it ends in EDU or .ac.uk means it is British website devoted to academic. So you can trust on it. So this is how all those websites are to be evaluated. Now, you see, you have got not only Google, you have got their compilation also done through slightly higher order term, integrating many of these websites. So if you give one term under, say, Alta Vista, it will search many websites, not only Google, and then pick up different items from that and give you a complete list. Otherwise, what is happening? We are again going by Google's philosophy of search and its page ranking. It is not the ideal one every time like that. They also change their policy without informing you. That's why such powerful Alta Vista kind of in search engines are very important, because about 40% variations is observed. If you just put one keyword in Google and the same keyword in Alta Vista, you'll find about 40% difference in the list hit. That's why please use different search engines. Then there are meta search engines which go further, like Metacrawler, Profusion, like that. So here spelling difference is also taken into account. Because color, we say C-O-L-O-U-R, and American write C-O-L-O-R. Labor, you know, many of the time those articles are not picked up. So all those things are taken into existence by these higher level search engines. Then there are some specific subject directories also through Yahoo search and all this kind of thing. So just find law, everything about law is available there. And this is where that Ranganathan's classification is important. The way Ranganathan has classified subject like that, that's why there is an article, was Ranganathan a Yahoo? Because Yahoo has used his principles for that Yahoo dictionary, development of directory, it is like that. There are various such websites. Yeah. Now this is very important, the search strategy.
Sir, just for a while, they don't know Ranganathan classification, that was between me and you. So.
Maybe remember, you were there, I showed one book was 300.72/BLA. Remember? So those first numbers are having particular subject relationship. 0 to 99, it has got religion, philosophy, all this kind of thing. 100 to 199, something like that. 500 to 509, general science. 510, to 519 mathematics, statistics. Like this, up to 1000, Dewey divided the whole knowledge in those boxes. And then those after decimal are particular. If it is related to India, then country number will come as 7, UK. Then 2 means further sub-region or subject-wise. So this is all those numbers after decimals, he has given a scheme. And he has been revising. There are now 22nd edition. This Dewey found out or gave this scheme in 1900, around that time. So 120 years have passed. So with each subject, new things, those decimals numbers have been changing, and every few years new edition is coming and books are sometimes reclassified. Ranganathan said, don't go by this kind of boxes. You use what is called one scheme, see the energy, see the personality. And he gave a difference called colon scheme. So he has differentiated two numbers or two names putting a colon. So it's called colon classification. So it has got different philosophy for classifying the documents. So if you are arranging the data on websites for subject, then that colon classification is a better than duodecimal classification. That is the point I was saying, and that's the article was written on. There was Ranganathan Yahoo, 100 years, in 1931 he gave that thing.
So that, that is one of the Yahoo. Contributions by Indians to information science.
He's called the,
which is very highly
he's
regarded,
called the father
regarded.
Of library science. His 5 laws of library science are till today valid. 1931 he gave this law. So Yahoo came recently, but it is using his scheme. So this article was written by a person who was working for Yahoo. It is available on the net, you can download it. Yeah, search. This is the way you should start. Start with a simple search. Dawkins evolution. Right? Just 2 words. When you put it, now we are using what is called Boolean algebra. We are not doing algebra on numbers, but on words. Like addition, subtraction. The same is extended by George Boole. That's what called Boolean algebra. When you write like this, it is called OR operation. Means the search engine will search those documents where either Dawkins or evolution has occurred. Some documents will have only Dawkins' name, no evolution. Some will have only evolution, but since it is OR, you will get a huge list. Right? So it is OR type. But you want specific, only those documents where both are coming, Dawkins and evolution, then either you can write plus Dawkins plus evolution or put in double inverted quotes. That is called AND operation. Means only those documents where both the words are occurring. So if you are given first option, you may get 5,000 documents. If you put the second option, it may reduce to 3,000. Those 2,000 are because they were not having both the words. So now you think of your strategy, whether you want to use first, second, or you want to have all those documents where both the words but no God term should appear. Then say minus God. So only those documents show where Dawkins and evolution, but nowhere the term God will appear. Now from 2,000, it may come to 500, because evolution, God, all those are generally related, talk together. But you are not interested in that part. So your search, you have further narrowed down, and you get only 500 documents to be searched like that. Or you can have one term, and you can have an expression, so that you put in single quote. So you have Dawkins plus creation theory, like this. So there are various ways. Or you are not very sure about spelling, and how it could be used. So just dimension and star, it's called wild card. So it could be, so it will pick up dimensions, dimensionality, dimensional, dimensioning, because first characters are matching. So if you are not very sure, then you can use wild card. So this could be starting point, then you can refine it further. So search is never done in one round. It should go 2-3 rounds. Once you get experience, once you see one of those documents, you will find out, oh, this kind of terms are also used. Then you can add and get more refined information. And then there are advanced search. You can make various combination of these. And then you can add this, along with this, I want only books. Along with this, I want only papers and all this kind of stuff. So it can be refined further. And that's why use this Boolean strategy, especially for online resources. See, even manuscripts, we have got National Manuscript Mission. If you are doing old translation or that kind of thing, the National Manuscript Mission started in 2003. You know, we have lost millions of manuscripts. People have taken it away to different, we have just given them free like that. So it was realized that we had lost such a treasure. So this mission by Government of India is trying to preserve as many manuscripts available in country. They are trying to get them, preserve them physically, digitize them like that. And that is its website. Its objectives are like this: boost scholarship, prepare a complete catalog of all the manuscripts, their digestion, physical preservation, and so on. So many centers they have set up in all over India, because you know manuscripts are spread all over India. So in Maharashtra there are two, Kolhapur and Thane, and one in Pune also. 31 resource centers and like that.
Here there may be information for these chemistry people. Actually recently they have started a project on healthcare related manuscripts, so preservation of that and transcription and translation of that. So particularly they are working in documentation on traditional entities and how it could be taken further. So grants are also available for such projects there.
Yes, and this is the metadata. See, they are digitizing, so manuscript number, author, 31 fields are there, you know, and in which format it was, because it creates four types of files: TIFF, GIF, two level, and thumbnail. So very elaborate process. So if you see, go to their website, they got complete details and what precaution they have taken, like that. And this is the current status: 42.03 lakh manuscripts information is available, 2.7 million data records put on this website. You can search today by subject or keyword and author. 2.96 lakhs covering 2.61 crore pages have been digitized, and 100 TB server is available like that. So if you want to go to this website, and you can get this free like that. And they bring out many periodicals also, and books also of all this manuscript. So go to their website and get all those details.
And maybe for computer science students, so if you are looking for the topics, here itself each individual you can find a variety of topics for PhD. Since manuscript research is one of the very important research area and upcoming also. So there also you can find submit the project proposals, get the grants and do the research.
Yeah, it is encouraged.
And this is national level recognition.
Yes.
Automatically it will be up to you coming to
at
you.
Least visit the website and see what they are doing. Very
yeah.
meticulous work they are
when
doing.
When they are saying digitize, the digitization itself can be done in various ways. So variety of parameters like economical and then many accessibility. So you can check how best you can contribute. That is also possible.
See, this is how they are bringing out so many research publications. I mean, those manuscripts are also subject to research by their people or academician. So Tathobodh, Samiksha, there's a periodical Kirtibodh publication of critical edition. So tremendous amount of work is available, and they bring out Kriti Rakshana, bi-monthly publication of this mission itself. And this is how the digitization whole setup is there, like that. Different parts of country. Okay. Now, fortunately, UGC has purchased India-wide licenses of many electronic databases, electronic journals, and colleges and universities are really member of that. And see how many constants are there. So JSTOR, Elsevier, they have tied up, they have paid lump sum amount for whole of India, academic world. Now it is up to you to use it like that. This may be slightly dated, I have not got the up to date, but you know, each subject wise, how many journals from all those internal are available to you free of cost, because UGC has paid that amount. Medical Science 494 journal, Philosophy 124. No. Computer Science 133, like that, you know, sir. You just go to your library and access them. It is all available. So, you know, if these sources are available and you are not using, then whom to blame? So just don't depend on Google. There are so many authentic and really freely available sources. Please use them. Because a couple of years back, they had surveyed and they say Mumbai University is the least user of this. This was the, you know, I had no face to face that person. He gave me the complete statistics. He showed that in last 6 months, some subjects, not a single entry. Nobody has touched. So that means you are not doing research in this area. You know, they're very awkward questions. Anyway, that is up to you. But availability is there now. So we cannot complain that this journal is not available now. So most of the standard journals are covered there. Now, Springer online journal, just to see how detailed it is like that. So if you go, how it works, electronic journals. Right? So here, you are given username and password. Once you, university library will give you out like that, then all details are there. Your name, everything appears there. And complete guidance is given like that. Just browse alphabetically, all the journal lists is coming, right? So either alphabetically or subject wise, the way you do it, it will appear, and all are accessible, you know, ABCD wise also. So first 50 of top 533 in mathematics they are showing. Explore any according to your need, you know, very systematically there. If you are very sure, you can start with G and see all from G. So for that particular journal, you click on that. So its thumbnail, complete picture will appear. From which volume all are available. Main areas, you know, they are all telling you. So whether I should read the journal or I should submit my paper, the journal you are getting. Hint from there, then all information that I showed you, the instruction author, authors, and then you can search. If you want to see particular issue or volume number, you can click on that. Now all the articles are appearing for that particular issue. Click on that. So it is showing a title, author, abstract. So for your reference, you can give all this information. If you want full text, you read this abstract and you are interested, okay, this is important, then click on full text and get full paper. Otherwise, skip it. Or you want only first page, you know, so many options are available to you in HTML format. Now full text in PDF. So, you know, no wise, who has no knowledge of computer use, complete guidance is given. Now this is how you design your interfaces. See, you develop software, but kind of interfaces for the users, that's why I'm showing you. This may be very elementary for most of you, but still, how to interface designing, we get some guidance. Right. Now, dairy industry, right? This is the keyword which has been put. So, you have got two entries, right? Now they are put in inverted commas, so both the words are there, then the article is picked up. Understand? Or even first term is there. Search within the result. Now within the results also you can search. Advanced search. Just see how they are organizing. Just you want references of that article, you can get those also. Same in HTML format. Different links to this article, you know the popularity of this article. You get really everything about that particular source. Then advanced search, variety of things. Advanced search query with asthma and children as keywords. There are large number of articles. So click on so you get complete variety, how many articles are there, how much is knowledge available. So this is how most of these advanced database search engines will be helping you. So first think about your topic, broad topic, a few keywords, start with search online, offline, then define your particular keywords and get a relevant article. So your searching time and efforts is minimized. And that's the advantage you have got. At our time, there was nothing like this. You had to sit whole day in the library, read, see each journal, each issue. If you are lucky to get, okay. Otherwise, do it again tomorrow. So lot, almost 1 year used to go in this kind of searches. Now you can save on this time because of these advances. But still, it is for only online. Huge amount of literature is there offline. But at least some part is saved in terms of money and time and energy like that.